Welcome guys to another tutorial about Apache NIFI. This video is a quick guide to the NIFI UI. This is the NIFI user interface. In the center, we have a blank canvas on which we can build our data flows. On the top left corner, there's a components toolbar. You can drag these components onto the canvas to build your data flow. And if you hover over a specific component, you'll see its name appearing. For example, we have here a processor, an input port, an output port, and so on. Let's start with the process group component. This component allows you to logically organize your data flows. Now, let me give you an example. Let's say we are a big data company, and we have a team that we can call the analytics team. This team works with NIFI to create data flows in order to ingest data from different sources, prepare it, and deliver it to different partners. Now let's translate this scenario using process groups. To use any component, you just have to drag it onto the canvas. Now it asks you to give your process group a name, and I'm going to name it Big Data Company and hit enter. As you can see, a box has been added to the canvas, and that is our process group. Now I'm going to go inside this process group by double clicking on it, and I'm going to create another process group. This time I'm going to name it Analytics Team. Hit enter. I'm going to repeat that all again, go inside the analytics team and create another process group that I'm going to call, data flow 1 and add it. Okay, you can also copy your process group just using Control C, Control V, or if you right click on it, you'll find the option to copy it here. You can also use the operate palette to copy your process group. I'm going to click on copy, and then next to it, I'm going to click on paste, and it'll replicate my process group. Now, the name is copy of data flow 1, so we would want to change that. Again, I'll go to the operate palette and click on configuration. Here, I can change the name of my process group, and I'm going to name it data flow 2. Click on apply. OK, and just close it. You can find what we call breadcrumbs along the bottom of the canvas, just here. So, for example, if I go inside data flow 1, you can see that the breadcrumbs changed, and it shows you where you are in the flow. It shows each process group that I entered to reach this depth. For example, here I am inside data flow 1, which is a data flow created by the analytics team, a team that belongs to a big data company. Also, you should note that each process group listed in the breadcrumbs is a link that will take you back up to that level in the flow. So for example, if I click on analytics team, it'll take me back up to the analytics team process group. Okay, so there's another useful component that I'd like to show you, which is the label component. Just go in to drag it and drop it onto the canvas. Here, it looks like a sticky note. You can resize it the way you want. And we use labels to kind of document our data flows. So to add some text to your label, you just have to double click on it. And here I'm going to type description of data flow 1. You can also change the font size here and then click on apply. There's also the possibility to change the color of your data, here in the operate palette. You just click on change color and then choose whatever color you want and click on apply. Just go into copy and paste my label here. I'm gonna place it here and then change the text so that it says description of data flow 2 and then click on apply. You can also delete a label here in the operate palette. You'll find the option to delete a label. But I'm not gonna delete any labels, I'm just going to leave it there. What else can I show you? Oh, the navigate palette here is kind of useful too. We use it to kind of navigate around the canvas, and you can also zoom in and out. So yeah, that's it for this video. There will be a part 2 where we'll be discussing the rest of the components that will actually help you build your data flow, like processors, for example. So if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below and I'll make sure to answer them. Thanks for watching this video and see you guys next time.